It's showtime!
Today's theme, edgy and hip, youthful rock and roll. The Cut, clipper and carving design Mohawk razored interior.
Hello, welcome to Backstage. We're in Florida, Boca Raton, which, by the way, doesn't that sound glamorous and fabulous? But you know what Boca Raton means? Mouth of the rat. Go figure. Anyway, I'm here in my room and check out the view. Fabulous. Anyway, this is gorgeous Jenna. We're gonna do a really cool haircut today. At this show, I am showing three collections. So this one is called The Edge, and let's get into the haircut. The sectioning, a mohawk section all the way through here. I'm gonna take the sides down nice and tight, and I think you're gonna really enjoy this hairstyle. Are you ready? You didn't realize you were gonna be in my room, did you, baby? So let's talk about this haircut. You have a choice to take away the sides by scissor over comb, or you can actually work with the razor. So you can see I'm getting acquainted with the hair right now. Scissor over comb up to my separating section, and the section is that of a mohawk. When I'm doing something like this, it's all about control and of course efficiency. How quickly can I remove this hair? Because it is removal, because I have something really fun planned for the next part, but still maintain control. You can see the hair is damp here, and I'm just really doing this to get the control, tidying up around the ear, and make sure it's all nice and neat and tidy. Of course, one could go in with the clippers, and in that case, you'd have the hair dry. It really depends on how long the hair is and how short you're going to go. I think that here, as we're going in around the face, it's nice to shape in nice and snug. And I really do want to go slowly and carefully because I am actually going to be carving into the hair with the clippers in a moment. So this is really about efficiency, snug. And is this scary to do? Yeah, I think it can be. You've really got to have the right client, model, guest to do this with. And Jenna is very playful. She's fun. She loves something that's creative. She's the type of girl that if you do not do something interesting, you're going to lose her. So here you can see I'm having her hold down her ear so I can get in nice and snug. She's got one of those naughty hairlines which grows up in the air. So obviously one's got to get nice and close through that part. And you can see just really getting it nice and snug. And I was actually trained to do all my close work through the scissors, and I really have not done very much in my career working with clippers. So it's not something that I would say you can't use or you shouldn't do. It was just at Sassoon's we weren't allowed to use them. Everything had to be freehand. And I think it's lovely to know how to use both so that you can see the pros and cons of taking hair down very, very close. So a couple of things that are very important. Obviously face shape is critically important. You know that I like to create a nice oval face shape and a straight plane. But I also, in a hairstyle like this, because it is short, want to be particularly mindful of the shape of the skull, how round the head is, if it's flat. Are there any scars that I need to be aware of that could possibly cause a problem with my hairstyle? Now, this hairstyle is going to have actually carved lines placed into it. So we're going to have some real fun here. So once you've got your base, then you can start working on your design. Now, you may want to draw this out on a piece of paper first because it's what is your inspiration. And obviously here, we're just going to come in super, super bold. And I'm being very, very gentle with my little tiny peanut clippers. And I'm coming in and I'm actually making a stronger, wider line there. And I have to tell you, this is the first time I've done a hairstyle of this nature
and certainly the first time I've done it on camera. So I was excited and scared all at the same time. And you know what? I think this is important. When was the last time you tried something new for the very first time? Now that I've done this once, I know what I'd like to do the next time, because everything's a learning experience, isn't it? And you know, all I can say is when you've got a strong classic foundation, you learn super, super quick from your discoveries, your trials, your errors, etc., etc. So as we're looking through here, I'm just cleaning up the perimeter so I can make a really lovely shape and be very specific. So here coming in vertically to create my line, and now doing some really bold angles right the way through. Now, could you do this with your scissors? Yes, absolutely you could. You could cut your line through, and you just have to be very gentle and very mindful that obviously you don't cut the scalp, which would be really scary, wouldn't it? And you can see here, my first time I went up vertically with the razor. Now you see I went back in with the scissors because I seem to have more control. So I decided I wanted to create this nice sort of tiered effect. I'm not going to do the same on the other side, probably because I couldn't do the same on the other side. Well, that's not true. I could, but I think that this kind of design would actually be better not to be matchy-matchy. Now, what's important about this is slow down, step back. Obviously, if I take the hair down super, super short, I'm not going to get the bold contrast. Here you can see I'm going in with my scissors and cutting more of a distinct line through there. And this is certainly the sort of hairstyle that's going to grow out super, super quick. So this sort of person would be back to you within a few weeks. So it's just a whole lot of fun to play with. So if you haven't done something like this before, it's about going out and finding the people who appreciate this. Remember, say what matters to people who care. So if you're talking about something fabulous like this, is edgy and dramatic, you've obviously got to find a candidate who appreciates that. Otherwise, you're completely wasting your time. This gives you so much creativity. You could take your inspiration from stained glass windows. You could take it from textile design. There's just so many cool things that you could do to get your inspiration. So here you can see, it. Basically, I'm removing the bulk. So it's like, let's cut to the chase and get rid of the hair that's excessive. Let's pull the ear down so we can get right the way around the ear and tidy up those little ends. And it's amazing how much ears jump around, isn't it? It's a shame you can't take them off and put them back on again. I've always said that. So anyway, coming through here, scissor over comb again, rhythm is important. The angle of the blade is also really, really important. You want to tilt slightly away from the head so that you're not horizontal to the head, you're just tilting away so that you're following the curvature of the head shape. When you're working on tricky hairlines, and this is definitely a naughty hairline, you've got to actually go in several different directions. So going against the hair and flowing through. Here again now, working with our little clipper and carving in some nice partings. And you can see coming in very, very close. And so this does require a steady hand. Don't drink too much coffee before doing this one. And just carving through. Step back, stop, look at the total shape, because in the stopping you can see where you're going. If you just get carried away and start cutting without stopping, you could make a mistake that makes it difficult to go anything other than, well, you can't do anything, can you? You can't go backwards, not in something like this. There's no cover up here. So just make sure that you're going slow and steady. I do think it's a good idea to have some drawings of what you'd like to do so that you have a theme of curves, circles, squares, whatever the shape may be, so that it really does become fun. And of course, color makes a very important statement about this, and you're going to see Jenna has some really wonderful color when we take a peek and see her on the stage. She was really a very, very cool young lady, and she knew how to rock out this hairstyle. So again, carving in. I think it's nice to have the graduation of the side go from super tight into being longer so that you've got more of a carpet effect. And you can see here, I learned from the first time that I didn't have as much control working vertically with my blade of the clipper. So you can see here, going in with the scissors, I feel like I have more control. And it made me feel a little squeamish at first, going this close to the scalp, because it's not something I do every day. So, you know, as I said, when you're brave and you try something new, you have to take very, very small steps to just make sure that what you're doing is truly, truly working. So here I'm now taking the hair in a little bit closer. I can see the perspective now, which is important, and just doing my finishing touches of this line. And you'll notice that the faux hawk comes to a V, which is very important. Otherwise a box can look strange on the top of the head. So here, starting in the center, at the place that's going to be the shortest, I thought rather than just do a square layer on the top, let's make it a little bit more interesting and let's create some jagged edges working with the razor. So you can see here that as I carve up, I'm creating some dramatic valleys and peaks. I'm also making sure my length is the same on the outside. So that's my cross check, making sure it's correct. Oh yeah, that's so cute, huh? And making sure that this texture is really fabulous. So what I'm doing here is from the crown, that's the shortest part, going to the longest part at the fringe. You can see nice light strokes. Now, when you hold the razor in this way, it should almost feel as though you're shaking someone's hand. So that's very important. So here I'm showing you the angle. So we're going from shorter at the crown to longer at the occipital bone into the existing length at the nape of the neck. And I think this will give it a little bit more of a different flair and also allow Jenna to have more versatility as she plays with this hairstyle. So you can see the hair at the nape is the original length of the hairstyle. And sometimes that can be a huge restriction. What do you have as the old hairstyle and how do you navigate around that to create a new hairstyle without the old one sort of shining through? The razor is important here because it gives you so much movement and texture. Notice I'm super light as I work through. You want to glide, you want to be soft, you want to float like a butterfly. You don't want to saw, you don't want to chop, you don't want to hit. So the lighter your touch, the more beautiful it will be, and the hair will not get torn or shredded. So make sure the hair is nice and wet for something like this and just glide through. Do play with the hair and look at how it's laying so that you can really see its personality. So now as I bring this hair back, see how I'm pointing in and creating even more valleys and peaks and a combination of short and long hair. So you can see Jenna's already got some old color in her hair here, and we're gonna have some fun as we take her into something really quite different. The perimeter is also very important. What's gonna happen when Jenna wears her hair down as well as up? So these pieces that could lay over the carved area are extremely important. We want to make sure that as they're draped around, it's a sweet fringe with a beautiful shape. So again, going in and creating valleys and peaks, I know I say that a lot, but that's exactly what it is. And it's a nice rhythm, so they're consistent. And here on my second side, you can see those lovely valleys and peaks, can't you? As they're laying over the shorter area. So this just gives it more design. And I think that's critically important because let's face it, a kid could go into a bathroom, get her dad's clippers, and she could clipper away her side and just chop into the top. There are plenty of kids on YouTube that are doing their hair themselves and teaching other kids how to do it. So we do have to add the quality to this so that within the rawness of this look, there truly is a couture design. Using the round brush blow dryer, because I do want to get some nice finish into the hair, because the hair is a little bit chemically compromised. Here, blow drying a wave in so that I can create some nice movement. You can see how that's kicking in there so I get the lift away. And just really a kind of a cute effect. So this is all about, you know, really great color. And I love that little plumage there. It's really very sweet, don't you think? And I love the way that the back has its own little personality. So it's a nice spin on a faux hawk that usually would be much, much longer on the top. So I think it's really, really cool. So let's just check out how fabulous Jenna is on stage and how she was at our photo shoot. And I think she's just really a beautiful young lady, and I just love how she rocks this hairstyle. I hope you've enjoyed this. Play with this, make it your own, and thank you for watching. Bye for now.
It's showtime!